G'day everyone, Raid0AU, and welcome to a new series on a game called Rising World. This game's a survival building game, produced by JIW-Games and being published by Keep It Simply Simple. And very much in early access at the moment. Few animations are a little bit wonky at the moment, but there is quite a lot in the game as far as building and things like that are concerned. So thought it'd be worth us having a... I've played around with it a little bit. Not a huge amount, but played around with it a little bit just to see what was going on with it, and thought it might be worth... Let's do a series and explore it a little bit further. So you can see we've got some wildlife around the place. A few mooses. Actually don't know what the plural for moose is. Is it mooses? Mooses? Meese? I don't know. But the world certainly is... certainly is a nice looking game. Okay, so we might come out of there. That's you see we've got snow over in the distance there. We've got some tundra over this way. Over some there. Coming into the grasslands. So like every survival game, basically first thing we want to do is we need to start collecting some resources. And main thing I want to look for is a nice area that I think I could build on. Because... effectively, at the moment, with this game, this is building, mining and building is what it's all about. So, we've got these cave systems. It's quite a deep cave from the looks of it. Yep. Got watermelon there, I'll take that. I think this is probably more of the cave. Got a mountain over there, might head over that way. Very deep caves. Oh, look at. Don't think I can attack this guy at the moment. I'm probably dead any second. So as you can see, it does have some wildlife that is rather aggressive. Kill this pig over here. Sure, you'd rather have the pig, surely. Surely. Some water here. This actually wouldn't be too bad a spot to build if it wasn't for... what is that? It's not a leopard, it's a jaguar, maybe? Well, there we go. Drawing in. Back to the respawn point. Now, did we lose anything? That's going to be the next question. Yep, lost everything. The bag's probably over there. Alright. Let's try that again, maybe. Oh, now we got a bear on us. Oh, really? Can I run away from the bear, maybe? Oh dear. So. Hopefully you can run away from stuff. That would be nice. No, he's still coming. Bloody hell. Alright. Let's see if he keeps following us. I would like to be near some mountains because I wouldn't mind digging into them. He's still coming. Bloody hell. We'll just keep going. He might forget about us one of these days. And then we'll probably run straight into something else. Goat over here. Oh, there's a cave over here. Oh, come on. Give us a break. Jeez. Pool of water there. It's quite nice. Got around the corner here. So, certainly the landscape is it's very nice. Nicely generated. Lost him finally? Maybe. That sounds like something growling. Yeah, it is. It's one of those. Alright. Let's head back this way. At the risk of running into our friend, the bear. Oh, there's a giraffe over there. See that in the distance? That's cool. That's really cool. Some sheep. Alright, there's Mr. Bear over there. There's a bear over there. Right. So, I am thinking, we've got some ore deposits around here. I am thinking we might just actually do an old Minecraft and dig ourselves a hole. I'm pretty sure this is iron here, so we'll mine the iron out. And we can use this as a bit of a hidey hole, I think. Hopefully some of these animals decide to move away. So you can see the animations here, a bit floaty. That'll all change. They will update those animations over time. You can see it's a voxel based world, so while it shares many principles with something like, say, Minecraft, it is based on the voxel system, so. Yeah, we could do with a bit of wood. And you start off with the axe and the pickaxe. And then just F to pick it up. And when you chop the trees, you just need to pick up all the pieces. And you'll find that some of them will drop these like seed or saplings that you can then plant. So I wonder what happened to Mr. Bear. Did he move on or is he still around? Because there was a big cave down here that I wouldn't mind getting to. It looks like there's a big cave over there as well. I want to make sure I don't run into Mr. Bear again. Hi, Mr. Piggy. This long grass makes it a little bit difficult to... water supply there. And this is probably not too bad a spot to... look at setting ourselves up. Reckon I could build out there. We've got the view of the giraffe. That's a very big giraffe though. Oh shit, that's the bear, isn't it? I think he was sleeping. Alright, well, I guess we're probably staying around here. So, let's chop some more trees down. I think to start off with, we're just going to be mining into the side of the hill. Make sure the tree doesn't fall on me. I just want to make some torches and some torch holders. Chop this tree down as well. Make sure you pick up the saplings, any saplings that are lying around. Got an eye for our, what's that, willow sapling. 25 copper ore. Alright, so that was copper ore. And we got birch saplings there. Okay. What we'll do is we'll just come down here and we'll plant these down here. So, three, and just right. And then four. Just pop those in so they can start growing to provide us with a few more trees. Some more trees up there. Let's actually go up the hill a bit. Oh, some more ore. Right. So you can see you do get ores around the place. Oh, we got some water just up above us, which is nice. Cave system in the mountain, so chances are we'll probably mine our way into that. That's nice. Oh, that's bright. Alright, so I think there's a decent amount to explore around this area. Got some good water supplies. Nice to know we got this water supply above us. So, might work our way on. Might just actually grab some water while we're here. Is that a hole? Not quite. Alright, so if we come up to the water and press F, we should drink some water. There we go. That's good. And here's our cave here. So, if we bring up I, and go to the crafting. So, small shelter. Maybe suitable to survive the first night. We need 32 sticks for that. Alright. So, resources. So, we need lumber. Just make a whole heap of lumber. Sticks. Do that. Okay, small shelter. We can craft the object. Alright, we want to place this down. Where are we going to craft? Where are we going to place it? I'll place it up by the water, I think. Place it up here. Okay. So we can sleep in there. It's a huge thing over there, isn't it? Big ravine or something. Alright. What else do we need? Let's have a look. Crafting. Fireplace. 9 stone. 1 piece of log. We got that. Alright. And we will place that just there. Okay. The sun's starting to go down. So okay. So we've still got plenty of sticks. Dirt. Alright, so initially, now there are various crafting stations that you can make. Basically, we've just got the workbench that we can make at the moment. Lights, torch. Okay, so it takes one stick. Got 32 of them. Let's make 10 torches. Oh, that's going to make us 20 torches. That's good. And torch mounts will do the same. Okay. So, with the torch mounts, what we can do, and might actually put one up here. Put that there. And select our torch, place that in there. The reason I'm doing this is that hopefully should be quite visible from the ground. So if something happens, we should be able to see our way back. That is the plan, anyway. Okay, we'll stick one there. Alright, I reckon we just mine in a bit further. Another torch, I think. Okay. Let's clear ourselves some headroom. Remembering that we saw that cave system, so interesting to see whether we actually mine into it. But the thing is, we want to be grabbing stone and things like that. There were various other ores around that we saw. So we can certainly be grabbing that. We want to be grabbing some iron to be able to make ourselves a weapon at least, so we can at least try and protect ourselves in case one of these animals decides that they don't like us again. I might just place this. Doesn't want to go on anywhere. Oh, there you go. Go there. Pop that in there. Okay. So we've dug ourselves a hole. Got a little camp set up here. Just drink a bit of water. But we do need some food, so we need to worry about, might need to worry about that in the morning. Yeah, so I think at the moment what we'll do is, you know what, let's do the crafting station. I could probably go over here, or the crafting table. Should have enough to, we need 16 lumber. Alright, so for lumber, there we go, 16 lumber, and then go to the crafting station, workbench, craft it. Okay. And we can place this just over here. There we go. Alright, so the workbench, if we access that, that will have a whole lot of other stuff in it. So we've got the resources, lumbers and stick, lights. You can see here there's a lot of other stuff, lanterns, garden torch, big torch, all sorts of different things in there. Tools, we've got pickaxe, axe, sickle for clearing grass, rolling pin, flattening dough or for chasing someone away, as it says. Scythe, cutting grass. What's a sickle for then? And collect plants. It's more efficient than a sickle. So, rake to smooth out the terrain. Sledgehammer for rock. And a hoe for growing stuff. And the utilities, what have we got? We've got a clock, we've got a compass. Compass would be useful. Bucket. And a canteen. One iron plate for a canteen, so we'll make that a priority so we can carry some water with us. Weapons. These are definitely something that we need to start looking at with those animals around. So only the three in here at the moment, but that'll be expanded as they go on, I imagine. Miscellaneous. Posters, blueprints, trash crank, grill, smoker, grill. Crafting station, so we got the workbench which we built here, and all of these have different textures that you can choose from. So if you're wanting to match, mix and match, so block bench to create our blocks for building, saw bench for furniture, anvil, we're going to need to make that fairly quickly, we need to find some iron ingots, smelting furnace, we definitely need this early on. So, to start smelting stuff, that's just a bigger version of it. Loom to, for thing, and workbench tier 2 for more advanced items. So, once again, different textures and things like that. Various ladders, wood, an old ladder, so old and metal. Signs, so we can use some signs to... guideposts and things like that. So I think we'll be making use of that. And scaffolding for building. So frame. Once again, various versions of it. So there we go. Alright, so that's our first day in Rising World. Didn't start off the best. There's our timer. Health's down a little bit, but I do need to just find some food to boost that up. We've got a good source of water here. We've got, as I said, there's some caves and things like that. There's various ores lying around in the rock face that we can look at mining out. So for now, I think I'm just going to go for a snooze. So we'll call the video here. Hope you've enjoyed what you've watched. If you have, please leave a like and subscribe. Look forward to seeing you all next time. I'm Rate Zero AU, signing out.